Hi guys, welcome to another session of Sanjeev Academy. So today we are going to discuss about electromagnetism. So today we are going to discuss about magnetic effects of a current. So we have all seen a captain in a ship having a magnetic compass. So what is the purpose of that compass? If it is a north pole or a south pole, suppose if it is a north pole, what does this compass do? It deflects. It identifies the, or it helps the captain for navigation purpose. So the effect of the magnetic property has been huge, because again, Earth, if you take two things are there, North Pole and South Pole respectively. There is one guy called Christian Oystedt. So he just told that the captain's thing, that if there is a magnet, okay, so what happens? The magnetic compass will get deflected. So which means if it is an electric carrying conductor, okay, for example, the conductor here is a magnetic compass, it will definitely deflect when there is a magnetic field. And also it is experienced that if I am holding one long strip of, for example, a steel rod, and I am passing a current through it, and if I am holding that particular iron rod, definitely I'll get the shock, because the current will be rotating around the magnetic field. So which means what? Current is directly related to the magnetic field. Whenever there is a magnetic field, current also will be there. Coming to an electromagnet, so we all know the various use of electromagnet. So electromagnet is not a permanent magnet, which means only if a current is given, it behaves like a magnet. For example, the compass. Compass doesn't deflect all the time. Only if there is a magnetic field on the opposite side, let it be north pole or south pole, it starts deflecting. So just like that, electromagnet is a magnet, only it lasts as a magnet when there is a current flow. So what does this actually include? It depends on the strength of the current, number of turns of the coil, and what material forming its core. What is the number of turns? These are the number of turns. So in a steel rod, if I am, what is this thing? The wires. If in steel rod, if I am winding down with the wires, what happened? It becomes an electromagnet, which means it responds to the magnetic field around it. And how do they tell the magnetic field? Number of magnetic lines passing through that particular surface. Now coming to electric motor. So there are two things. One is motor, another is generator. For example, let's take in our household itself. What is a motor? So motor is nothing but, for example, we are using what? Our water pump. Water pump. So which means definitely motor is involved. But if it does not switch on the motor pump switch, will we get the water? No, we won't get that water. So which means motor is a device which converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. For example, only if I switch on that particular device, water will come. But for that water to come, what is required? Mechanical force is required. So what is electric motor? It converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. And one more thing regarding this, there is something called mechanical to electrical energy. Mechanical to electrical energy. For example, generator. What is generator? It is a device which converts mechanical to electrical energy. For example, let's take a dam. Okay, from dam what we are getting? Water. First of all, water. Second thing, what? Electricity. For example, if you are making that water to flow through a turbine, if you are making that water to flow through the turbine, we get what? Mechanical energy. So that kind of huge force of the water, we put it to a turbine and convert into electrical energy. So what is a generator? It converts mechanical to electrical. But motor is just the reverse of it. Even though you don't have the generator, I'll just tell you that's it. Now coming to electromagnetic induction, but if we discuss like this, EMF is induced in the coil when there is change in magnetic flux, we will never ever learn about this. Okay, if I am byhearting this topic, I am not gonna learn. So what I told, if we are gonna learn through the book, we are never ever gonna learn this particular topic, electromagnetic induction. So draw two coils. These are two coils, coil 1, coil A, and coil B. and these are placed very close to each other, which means very close. And for coil 1, I am supplying a voltage V. So last session we have learned about current electricity, voltage is there, battery. Okay, we have connected a battery. And what happens to the voltage? Current is passing through this coil. So what happens? This current induces an EMF. So what is EMF? Maximum voltage. So, but remember, this coil B, we do not have any voltage supply. It is just a coil. Okay, but what happens due to induced EMF? This second coil starts vibrating. It starts what? Vibrating. Okay, it starts vibrating. Why? To oppose the induced EMF. To oppose what? The induced EMF. To oppose the induced EMF. While producing a flux. Now you guys might be wondering, what is flux? That also I'll draw and show you. Let this be a surface. Number of lines passing through a surface. Number of lines passing through a surface is called what? Flux. So number of electric lines passing through a surface is called electric flux. But what is this topic all about? Magnetic current. So here, what flux will get? Magnetic flux. So just draw this thing surface. What are these lines? Magnetic lines. So number of magnetic lines passing surface is called what? Magnetic flux. So what is happening in this? Voltage is given, current is produced, and due to the current, what happens? An EMF is induced in circuit, and due to this induced EMF, the second coil gets vibrated, and due to this vibration, what happens? Due to this vibration, it produces a flux. What flux? Magnetic flux. What is magnetic flux? Number of lines passing through that particular surface. To oppose that particular what? EMF. So this is called Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So if you are able to understand in this simpler format, we can learn it without by hearting. So this is what is being discussed in this particular slide. So you can just pause the slide and you can just go through this. And transformer. So we have all seen what is a transformer. Okay, so what is a transformer? Transformer is a device which converts from low voltage to high voltage or high voltage to low voltage. So suppose, and what is the principle used in transformers? Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. The topic which I discussed, right? That is the same principle for what? The construction and the working principle of transformer. What is the thing? Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction respectively. So it consists of two turns. One is the primary and another is secondary. So suppose the primary turns are more, means it is a step down transformer. Or else if the secondary turns are more, it is a step up transformer. So these are the things just now what I discussed. And one more thing, step up transformer means what? The turns in the secondary side is more. You can see the difference in the two things. There are a lot of difference. Here the turns are less, the turns are more. Here in step down, the primary side turns are more, secondary turns are less. So whatever I discussed last, it's true. And what is step up transformer? Converts low to high voltage. What is step down transformer? Converts high to low voltage respectively. So everything depends on turns. Now here you can see EP, ES, EP. ES stands for secondary voltage. EP stands for primary voltage respectively. Okay, and these are some of the condition which you should learn for the working of the transformer. But again, remember one thing while writing for the in the exam point of view, if they ask you the working principle, don't forget to write about Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. That is the working principle of transformer and generator. So if you are able to learn the previous thing, we can easily learn this thing also.